What's happening again there, YouTube? Your good friend Dasmer coming at you. What's the haps? What's happening? What's the crack? Hey, hey, I'm back. Anyways, sorry about the long absence there. So yesterday, actually, I picked up NBA 2K11, picked up the old shticks there. I haven't even turned on my Xbox lately. Picked up in practice a little bit and then got into a game of Vladimir. You know, same result. Had a good game, as you saw there. And, we ended up losing. So then I picked up my point guard. Oh, yeah, that's my point guard. So I was playing with my point guard. And by the way, if you want to play point guard in NBA 2K11 on easy mode, pick the three-point specialist, man. It's stupid. That guy, Lonnie Rivers, by the way, great name. Lonnie Rivers has got fucking stupid stats, man. Anyways, picked that up. And, pretty much what's ruined my player for me is playing center and then going to playing point guard. It's like a completely different gaming experience. You know, here's hoping that's something that gets sorted out there in NBA 2K12. It was such an advance and so much stuff was put into it, but it looks like they just sort of ran out of time. And, you know, my player mode sort of felt half done is, the way I feel about it. So going to put down my player mode for a bit, but don't want to put down 2K11. So I never really played association at all. So what I ended up doing was setting up an association, and here we go. Take it through me picking a team. I had a bit of a blonde moment there. I was like, who am I going to be? And I wanted to be the Hawks. I'm here in Toronto, so I didn't want to be the Purple Dinos. I did an association. I think I played six games out of it, and then I got into my player mode. So, but my buddy BA was... that's basically what he played from the first 2 months of that game. Was he was playing association and I was playing my player, and then I just stopped playing and he started playing my player. Well, anyways, man, that's a different story. So yeah, just going through the fantasy draft here, I ended up picking 10th. Whatever, it is what it is. And you can see me drafting my team here. I'm kind of interested in see how this goes, because what BA was telling me was pretty much you got a guy for like 4 or 5 years, maybe sometimes six, and then pretty much after that, unless you want to completely cap hoop your team, you let him go in his little merry way, and you got to just get that good circular flow going there. So yeah, I'm interested and looking forward to the challenge. So while we're on the topic of basketball here. Your good friend Dasmerg, what does he think about the old NBA finals there? And, I'll put it this way to you. I'm an NBA fan. I've been watching since, like, the, Magic Bird days. And then the last, I'd say, 2-3 years, kind of not been paying too much attention. Watch a game here and there. Watch the finals. And that's about it, really. So, it's really interesting to see the game evolve yet again. There's no more really big man, low post D-type game anymore. I was just shocked at how many three-pointers were shot, like, all through the playoffs. That was nuts, man, and if we see that continue, we'll have to see how that affects the game down the road, especially for our American friends there, for good old Team USA, because if you remember, when we started getting into the, we got away from the skill set game and more of a, the push and dunk and the high school kids coming in, and Team USA sort of really suffered when they got out on the world stage there, because the big market is still and probably will be for quite some time will be in the United States for basketball, but there's some other countries out there with some pretty good programs, considering here in Canada we invented the fucking game and we have the kind of team. Yeah, I never really understood that, and it's like the world's easiest game to play. All you need is, a court and a ball. So that's why soccer is so popular internationally, because all you need is a net and a ball. But that's another topic for another day. So yeah, pretty much, I watched from the semifinals on, every single game on. I was a little bit shocked at Chicago. I really thought they were going to knock off Miami. That's still a young team. I think they got a really bright future there. Joakim Noah, I think, was pretty jokey. Is he really the only way to put it to you, man, is what I thought. He should have run wild in that series, but really he seems more of a second point guard is the way he plays. And, I don't know that that's really the way, the way forward there. And really, to get away from any of the haterade there, my thoughts was that the better, deeper team won. And, you know, how many times we see that happen in the NBA Finals is that the better, deeper team won. And not to sound, you know, not to sound like a hater or something, you know, I just think as the reality is for the Heat is you can't win a championship with five starters and essentially no bench to go to. And I was actually kind of quite shocked that the Heat were able to actually go, you know, and it is a credit, actually, to the big three there that they were able to carry that team right into the playoffs and that far into the playoffs, man. Because, you know, to me, they really had no business going that deep. And it was only a matter of time. The deeper they got, it was only a matter of time before they just ran into a team that was, you know, that can just, you know, put out 7-8 guys out there. And, you know, there was really no drop-off. And I think the outcome probably would have been a lot worse if, like, a Caron Butler was not injured. So, but anyways, better, deeper team won. Heat's prospects still look pretty good, man. Well, that is if there is basketball next year. So, I do have some footage. I did play my first game out of my association here. So, check out for that. It'll probably be sometime this week. And thanks for watching again, YouTube. Your good friend Dasmerg's back. Check you later.